Hello everyone, in the previous video you learnt about the stem and our today's topic is the leaf. So let's begin. Look at the different parts of leaf in figure 8.10. So here is our picture. So the flat green portion of a leaf is called lamina or leaf plate. So look at this whole flat area. This whole flat area is known as lamina, clear? And the another name for this is leaf blade, clear? So this is the main part of this leaf blade or leaf lamina, even the base of it, clear? And this part, this whole part is attached to the by a stem, and the stem is this one, a narrow short stalk, and this is known as petiole, clear? So this leaf is attached to the petiole of a stem, okay? And observe a leaf closely. Can you see some lines on the leaf? Can you see the lines? These dark green lines, okay? So what are these lines called? Okay, so these lines are called veins. What do we call? Vein, clear? So this is a midrib, that means a main vein of this leaf, clear? And even the another name for midrib is main vein, clear? Okay, and this midrib is directly attached to the petiole, clear? And this midrib further divides into the small veins, and these veins are known as side veins. Veins or side veins. So you can easily find the difference between vein and midrib or main vein. So midrib is main vein and these veins are side veins, clear? So now check the arrangement of these veins on the leaf, please. Please. So these are the arrangement of these veins onto the leaf. And this arrangement is known as leaf venation. That means an arrangement of these side veins on the base of a leaf is called leaf venation. Clear? So next, move to our next topic. That is an activity. Observe the veins in the leaves of grass, maize or wheat. Plants that have fibrous roots, compare them with the veins in radish, carrot or tulsi. Plants that have tap roots, what difference do you find? Clear? So what do we need to do in this activity? You will take two different leaves, okay, like maize or wheat, and even with the grass. So first, one you will take of grass and the another between both the leaves, okay? Even you can take maize and the wheat also, okay? And then observe the venation, that means arrangement of veins onto the leaf, clear? So the veins in plants with fibrous roots are parallel to each other along the length of the leaf, and this is called parallel venation. So look at this picture carefully. Its veins are straight, clear, parallel, and this kind of venation always be in the fibrous roots, okay? That means a plant has fibrous roots, then the venation of these its leaves would be parallel, clear? And the next one we have, in plants that have tap roots, the veins form a net like design on the both sides of the leaf, and this is called reticulate venation. Got it? So if the plant has tap roots, that means its leaves venation would be reticulate. That means they are not parallel, they are opposite. So look at this picture carefully. Here venation is parallel, all are equal in length, and but not in this. So like this is midrib and we have these small side veins. Got it? So These are the two different venations, parallel venation and reticulate venation. Clear? Let's move to the functions of a leaf. First one we have, why are leaves green in color? So first of all, the leaf means what gives the green color to the leaves? This is due to the presence of a green pigment called chlorophyll. Clear? And leaves make food in the presence of sunlight with the help of water from the soil and carbon dioxide in the air. Clear? So first of all, what is chlorophyll? So students, chlorophyll, this word has come from Greek word, that is chlorophyllon, and where chloro means pale green color and phyllon means leaf. Okay, phyllon is shortened as phyll. Okay, so phyll means leaf. Clear? So what is chlorophyll? Pale green color of a leaf. Clear? So this chlorophyll gives green color to the leaf. So chlorophyll traps the sunlight and thus provides energy to the plant for making food. And this process of making food by the leaves is called photosynthesis. Okay, so students, this chlorophyll traps the sunlight and it provides energy to the plant to making food. Okay, because we also need some energy to cook our food. So same, these plants also need some energy to cook their food. Clear? So that is come from chlorophyll. Clear? And the process of making food by the leaves is called photosynthesis. So students, let's understand about the photosynthesis first. So what is photosynthesis? Photo means light. Clear? So plants use sunlight from the sun. Clear? Synthesis means to put together. That means what do they put together? Like water, carbon dioxide and soil. Clear? So when all these things combine, then the leaves produce their fruit. Okay, they prepare their food, and that food is known as glucose. It is actually a sugar. Okay, and then further changes into starch. Okay, so what is starch? So starch is an extra food that is prepared by the plant or stored by the plant in the different parts of it, like roots, fruits, leaves and stems. Clear? So extra food, that is starch, it is stored in these different parts of the plant. Clear? So the food that the leaf prepares is a kind of sugar called glucose. The glucose may further change into starch before the plant stores it. Plants use some of this food to perform their life functions and store the rest in fruits, roots and stems or leaves. In this way, leaves provide food to the entire living world. Clear? So first of all, means during this process, photosynthesis, leaves prepare glucose. And then this glucose further change into starch, and this starch as extra food stored in the different parts of plant. Got it? So let's move to the next activity, that is activity 7, experimental investigation to test for starch in green leaves. So in this we have said that starch is an extra food and stored in the leaves also. Clear? So how can we find some starch present in the leaves? So let's see what can be the experiment for this. Look at this carefully. Food is made in leaves. Some food should therefore be present in all green leaves. We can test leaves for the presence of starch using iodine solution. When iodine solution is added to the starch, it turns blue black. Clear, sir? First of all, what do we need to find some starch in the leaf? Just check the pictures carefully. In the first step, you just need to boil leaf in the beaker having some water in it. Clear? And in the next one, boil in spirit. Okay, got it? In water bath. So, you can add even alcohol. Actually, spirit and alcohol both are quite similar. Okay, so you can add some spirit in this test tube and boil it in this water. And afterwards, just put the leaf outside and wash it with the cold water. Here water should be cold. Got it? And after that you will just take this leaf out and put in a petri dish. This is called petri dish, and add some iodine solution. So with the help of a dropper, you just put some drops onto the leaf. Okay, and what would happen then? Wherever the starch present in the leaf, then this only those areas, okay, those areas will turn into blue or black in color, and this change shows us starch present in it. Clear? So students, our session over here. Okay, and so students, today's session is over. Okay, in the next session we will learn something about the another activities. Okay, so till that you need to practice. What do we need to practice? The leaf, okay, and the different parts of it, and the venation and function of leaf, that means only about the chlorophyll and the photosynthesis. Clear?